Well, a lot to talk these days about the need for austerity, cutting. But in his first ever daily rant, a premiere of sorts, Mark Ames warns all of us that deep cuts can be far more dangerous than you might recognize. Mark, founder of TheExiledOnline.com, and my friend, the mic is yours.
Thanks, Dylan. Austerity, that's the big word that's supposed to define 2011. Austerity is defined by the Oxford Dictionary as difficult economic conditions created by government measures to reduce a budget deficit. But everyone seems to prefer the Merriam-Webster's definition of austerity, extreme or enforced economy. I guess because their definition sounds so impersonal, like a force of nature. The incoming Republican Congress is promising to deliver a megadose of austerity this year, and the media and financial elites are telling us that we need a major dose of austerity for our own good, whether we like it or not. But what none of the dictionaries or politicians or financial experts are telling us is that austerity has been tried before many times, which might make you think, oh great, so it's been tried and it works, right? And that's where things get a little tricky. For example, one of the most infamous austerity programs was tried out in Germany in 1930 by Chancellor Brüning, one of those fiscal responsibility buffs who was sure that the answer to Germany's economic problems was to balance the budget and strengthen the currency by slashing unemployment benefits, pensions and wages, hiking taxes, and sticking to the gold standard. The result? Unemployment exploded, riots in the streets, the collapse of democracy, and the rise of Adolf Hitler. The rest is history. But hey, at least he got that deficit under control. I saw how austerity works with my own eyes when I worked in Russia in the 1990s, when a bunch of Harvard boys and Larry Summers force-fed austerity to that country in exchange for loans. The result? By the end of the 1990s, the Russian economy had totally collapsed. The population shrank by millions, and democracy was replaced by Vladimir Putin. So now there are two ways to look at this austerity they're promising us this year. One way is, it's completely insane, and you've got to be freaking kidding. That's one way. Another way, though, is to look at it from the eyes of the establishment, the top 0.1% of the political and financial elite, who clearly must know what they're doing, right? Yeah, these are the same bunch of degenerates who Pied Pipered America into two disastrous wars before cakewalking the entire financial system over the cliff in the worst crash in nearly a century. In other words, these guys get it. And what they're telling America today is, look, John Q. Public, your days of sponging off me, John Q. Gulp III, are over. No more free lunches, pal. Time for a dose of Dr. Von Hayek's austerity medicine. No pain, no gain. For us, that is.
Incredible lessons in history, Mark, and incredibly well done on your part. We should all do some studying before we have too much more of this debate. Thank you, Mark. That does it for us. I am Dylan Radigan. Hardball's up right now.